If parts of the systems of 5th edition bore or annoy you, it's often that you come up with your own homebrew rules to adjust it. I have my own rules in Revival because I think in 5th edition it feels too free, and each death should actually really increase the odds of you never being able to come back. I have my own homebrew rules on undefined magic items because I think they should be more mysterious and unique than anyone being able to sit down for an hour and then fully understand everything that they do. It feels a little bit disappointing to me. You don't see them often, but there's a lot of rules referred to as variant rules in the DM's guide, which can replace existing rules. You don't see these much because in all the different D&D streams I've seen, I think the only one I've ever seen implemented is Variant Encumbrance, which is exclusively done on Arcane Arcade. I'm sure plenty of other streams actually use variant rules, but I haven't seen any myself. Before we get into actually discussing variant rules, let's talk about the benefit of them. Often in D&D and other TTRPGs, you get really sick of certain rules and want to replace them, and these variant rules exist to make that job a lot easier for you, since possible changes to systems actually have official support. A different tabletop RPG called Pathfinder many years ago released a book called Pathfinder Unchained, which was exclusively filled with different rules and systems to play the game with. It included 4 class reworks, an update to multi-classing, character progression between leveling up, bringing skills into groups and rather unlocking them individually, a complete action economy rework, changing how multi-attacks work, changing spellcasting, and yeah, this book basically just completely changed the game. But it's pretty great. Barbarians become this stance change character, crafting rules are now actually usable and fun, and honestly, it addresses a lot of my issues with the system. But I never got to use it because I'm not going to ask my players to learn an update to an already very complicated system. So I think these variant rules are honestly pretty great. So where do they come in 5th edition? Well, unfortunately, there's no simple chapter in the DM's guide that just lists all the different variant rules you can play. You have to find the rules that they're replacing first. But let's go through it. Firstly, we have Variant Encumbrance. This rule is designed to make high-strength characters more valuable in the game. Essentially, you have a capacity of 5 times your strength score, and if you carry more than that, you're encumbered. If you carry more than 10 times, you're heavily encumbered. A single level encumbrance isn't too bad, your speed just drops by 10. But if you're heavily encumbered, your speed drops by another 10, and you get disadvantage on basically every single physical activity. I do not like this rule. I recently started a campaign where I was trying it, and it's mostly just frustrating, especially since everyone starts with 20 pounds of rations that guarantees they'll start encumbered, if not heavily encumbered. So there's no reasonable way to run both a campaign where your rations and camping equipment matters while also using this realistic carrying capacity rule, unless you want your game to turn into a puzzle game where you divvy up items to try and minimize encumbrance. The rule is fine, I just think it's really brutal. Next, we have Variant Ability Check Proficiency. Essentially, rather than choosing your skill proficiencies from a specific list of skills, you simply gain proficiency with all roles related to 2 ability scores. One is determined by your class, and the other is determined by your background. This rule's alright, it makes people good at lots of things, so it's probably a really good rule if you have a very small group. Next is Background Proficiencies. Basically, the idea of this one is you ignore all your class skill proficiencies and instead exclusively use your background to determine them. For example, if you want persuasion and deception, maybe a charlatan background is what you want to start with. I think this creates a realistic game, but isn't particularly great. There's also a variant rule that adjusts your proficiency based on your personality traits, which basically you tailor your proficiencies to match your personality traits. This one just seems like a worse version of background proficiencies. Hero points is a super weird entry that I think would be really cool in some campaigns. Every time you gain a level, you lose all of your hero points and gain an amount equal to 5 plus half your level. You can then spend these to add a d6 to your roll or automatically succeed on death saving throw. I think these rules are really cool because they add a resource to your players that they're encouraged to use because they lose them each time they level. I very much like this rule, but I think using it will make your players much more powerful. Maybe it's a good rule if your campaign's extremely difficult and you want to give your players an edge. Another really weird variant rule is Honor and Sanity. These are your 7th and 8th ability scores and work like your other ability scores when making your character. Honor is really weird. Even the books don't really fully explain what honor checks mean. It gives a few examples, but it's vague if you want your rolls to be high or low. On the other hand, Sanity is very interesting, although it works exactly how you'd expect. Sanity can be used in horror-themed campaigns to really add in an extra level of fear into your games. I highly recommend this rule if you run a campaign like Curse of Strahd. Next is a handful of healing rules. First we have Healing Kit Dependency, which simply doesn't let you heal with hit dice unless a healer's kit being used on you. This is alright. If you want short rest to be less abusable, this is like a decent rule, but I don't really think you need it. Healing Surges, on the other hand, allow you to heal so much in your games. Once between all your rests, a character can use an action to burn a bunch of their hit dice to roll them and heal from them. I think this would be great in a kind of campy campaign, like a Monster Hunter themed campaign, or another type of your campaign where your players are supposed to be epic heroes, but probably not for your regular standard campaign. Lastly, there's Slow Natural Healing, which forces your players to use hit dice to heal from a long rest. This is really brutal, but I think it could be great in some campaigns and dungeon crawl campaigns, since you can't just reset your character by going to sleep. Speaking of rests, wouldn't you know it, there's variants for rests too. We have two that are on completely different sides. We have Epic Heroism, where a short rest is 5 minutes, and a long rest is only an hour, which is incredible. The complete opposite of the scale is Gritty Realism, where a short rest is 8 hours, and a long rest is 7 days. Wow, both of these are just... wow. Yeah, I don't use either of these, but I think they could really fit depending on your campaign. I'm not going to get into the firearms rules, but they do exist and they change the game quite a bit. I will also mention but not get into explosives and alien technology. Basically, these rules just add a bunch of equipment with special rules about them. They can be pretty cool, but I made my own rules for firearms because I don't just want them to be mechanical bows in my campaign. Next is by far the most unique variant rule of all time that I desperately want to run a campaign with, but I have no idea how to pull it off. Plot points. Every player in the campaign gets one plot point. They can spend it at any point to just completely overhaul the campaign. A player who's getting frustrated with how difficult a puzzle with could spend their point to announce that they suddenly find a secret door to the next area. Then there's a variant on this variant rule, which forces the character to the right of that player spending the point to make something to mess with the first player's thing, like maybe the door that just appeared is now trapped. And then there's a variant to this called, and I'm not joking, the gods must be crazy, which is the real reason I love this variant rule. A player can spend their plot point to forcibly take over the campaign and become the new DM. The old DM would have an NPC ready that becomes their character. This would create incredibly improv games where the game goes completely all over the place and doesn't make any sense. It would be a blast with the right people. Also, it's worth mentioning that nobody gets their plot points back until everyone at the table spends theirs, which is pretty great. I love this rule and I'll probably never use it. Next we have initiative rules. First is what I consider to be a pretty lame one, which just gives everyone passive initiative. I don't like this, it makes the game easier for DMs, but it's pretty boring. Next we have side initiative, which is awesome. Each faction in a fight all acts at the same time, with the creatures in each faction deciding what they're going to do in what order. So the players can work out what order they want to do their actions in. Maybe the healer will sit back and wait to see if anyone gets hit by an opportunity attack before taking their turn. Or maybe they want to go first to cast Bless on all their allies. This is great. After that, we have Speed Factor, which I actually use in my campaign, albeit a very gutted version of it. I mostly just like the base idea of it, and not really the full thing. The idea is at the start of each round of initiative, all creatures declare their actions before any turns play out, and then everyone rolls initiative to decide what order that happens in. You get a modifier depending on what you declare. I think this rule's really clunky, but I love the aspect of it where you re-roll initiative each round. It really keeps everyone on their feet. I definitely wouldn't use it though if I wasn't using an online initiative tracker. Next is a bunch of variant actions. Honestly, I think all of them but Mark should just be baseline. Most of these just give you extra options like disarming enemies, overrunning an enemy. I just don't like Mark because there's no reason you would ever not use it because it doesn't cost you anything. There's a rule that allows ranged weapons to hit the cover that targets of the attacker taking. This doesn't really change anything unless they're using another creature as cover, so the rule's pretty eh. Now there's a lingering injuries rule. This rule is great if you want to kill all your players all of the time. There's a table of major injuries that you apply in certain conditions, doing things like taking away a limb, an eye, breaking ribs, or causing internal injuries. You choose to make these whenever a crit occurs, whenever a creature drops 0 hit points, or whenever they fail a death save by 5 or more. This rule's really rough and I don't like it, but I think if you want to make your campaign really dangerous and really deadly, you can use it pretty well. Next, we have the System Shock table. This is another rule that I use a modified version of. Basically, whenever a creature takes half or more of their max hit points in one attack, they need to make a con save or suffer an awful immediate effect. They could immediately drop to zero, be stunned, or can't take reactions. I think this rule is way too rough, and I use a similar rule except being effective causes you to suffer from fight or flight on your next turn, giving you a set of disadvantages I've listed up. Lastly, the final variant rule I've listed that I could find is spell points. These are actually meant to be used for making your own spellcasting class, but you could absolutely just replace spell slots with them. I have a player that wants to make their own homebrew class using a system like this, so I dug it up to try and help them out. Even though 6 and higher level spells are limited to a single use a day with the system, I think it needs some adjustment prior to use because a 20th level spellcaster could use all of their 9th to 6th level spells and then cast a 5th level spell 12 times, which I just think is absurd. I do like this system, however, I think it's really unique. That's all of the variant rules I could find. I think the great thing about variant rules is reading them, adjusting them, and then taking them for your own campaign. And I suppose if you really want to be mean, you can make a campaign where long rests take 7 days, and you have to use a healer's kit to actually heal for them, and you have to spend hit dice for a long rest. Plus, you implement the lingering injuries and system shock, and as long as it's fun for you and your players, that's great. Me personally, I don't know. I like some of the initiative variants, so I'll probably adjust and steal them all, and I think system shock would be great if it was much more tame. Thanks for watching.